Hello, I'm Mensah Augustine. Welcome to my series on differential equations. Now, in this tutorial, we'll be looking at how to determine that a given differential equation is exact or non-exact. So join me as we go through each of the seven questions one after the other. Now, if we have m of x y dx plus n of x y dy equal to zero, then this differential equation is exact if and only if the m x y with respect to the y is equal to the n of x y with respect to del x. So in each case, we are going to verify whether the partial derivative of m with respect to y will be equal to the partial derivative of n with respect to x. Now let's take the first one. If we take the first one, then it means that this will be our m, and then the whole of this will be our n. So if we take the first one, we are going to have our del m. So instead of the m, I'm going to put the function there, that is cosine of y. So del cosine of y on del x, sorry, del y will give us what? If we differentiate cosine of y, we are going to get negative sine y. And then for del n, you take the whole of this. So you are going to have del on del x, and the function is y squared minus x sine y. So now, if we differentiate this partially with respect to x, it means that we are holding the y term constant. So let us cover the y term. Very simple. And then we cover this y term. So what will happen? If we differentiate a constant, we get zero. So here, if we differentiate y squared, it is zero, because y squared is a constant. If we differentiate sine y, it will be zero. So we are not going to use the product rule here. Since sine contains y, this is just a constant. So if we differentiate negative x, if you differentiate negative x, we are getting negative 1. So here, we are going to get negative 1 times sine y. And that will give us sine y. Very simple as that. So it follows that the derivative of the partial derivative of m with respect to y is equal to the partial derivative of n with respect to x. So this equation 1 is exact. If it is exact, I will write there capital E. I write the capital E. So the first one is exact, and if it is not exact, I'll write in front capital N as our notation. So let's move on. Let's take the second one. If we take the second one, we are going to use this as our M and this as our N. So for the second one, del M respect to del X will be equal to del del x into bracket y minus x y squared plus 2y e to the power x. Now here we hold, we hold x as a constant. So if we differentiate one y, we are going to get 1. Here x is a constant. If we differentiate y squared, we are going to get 2y, and we multiply it by the constant, so it will be negative 2xy. Very simple as that. Here, e to the power x is a constant, so we will not touch it. If we differentiate 2y, we will get 2. So, plus 2e to the power x. Please note the derivative, very simple. Here, we are differentiating partially with respect to y. So if there's anything that does not contain y, it is a constant. So
So here, this x is a constant. So we just differentiate y squared to get to a 2y and then multiply it by x to get 2xy. Here, e to the power x is also a constant. So you cover it. If we differentiate this y, you get 2. So 2 times the constant. So that's what we have. Now, if we take del n on del x, which is equal to del del x, and what is our n? 2x squared y plus 2x. Oh, sorry. It is x minus x squared y plus 2e to the power x. So here, if we differentiate x, you get 1. If we differentiate this, y is a constant, so you will not touch it. If you differentiate x squared, you get negative 2x and you bring the y. Here, if you differentiate e to the power x, you get the same e to the power x. So plus 2e to the power x. Now you can see that this and this are the same. So here we write capital E. That is exact. Now let's go to number 3. So if we consider the number 3, we are going to have this as our m and this as our n. So if we take del m on del y, we are going to have del y into bracket 3x plus 6 on y. And here, this is the same as del y into bracket 3x plus 6 times y to the power negative 1. Please note that one very carefully. So here, we are differentiating with respect to y. So this 3x becomes a constant. So don't touch it. So if you differentiate a constant, you get 0. Now if you want to differentiate, you multiply 6 by negative 1 to get negative 6. And you subtract 1 from to get negative 2. So here, this one will become 6 divided by y squared. Very simple as that. Now let's take the next one. That one, we are taking del n, this is n, with respect to del x. And is equal to del x into bracket, x squared divided by y plus 3y divided by x. This is the same as del x into bracket, x squared y to the power negative 1 plus 3y x to the power negative 1. So since you are differentiating with respect to x, y becomes a constant. So you just differentiate x squared to get 2x, then bring y to the power negative 1. We differentiate this, we have negative 1 times 2 divided by negative 3. Y is a constant. If we subtract 1 from this, we get x to the power negative 2. So this one, we have 2x divided by y minus 3y divided by x squared. So clearly, we can see that del n with respect to del x is not equal to del m with respect to del y. So this one is non-exact. This one is non-exact. Now let's just tackle question 4. Okay, so question 4, we have our m to be this and then our n to be this. So here, del m on del y will give us del y into bracket 2xy squared plus 2y. And that one will give us 4xy. If we differentiate respect to y, 2x is a constant. So if we differentiate these two, we can multiply these two to first to get 4. We take one from this to get our y plus 2. If we differentiate 2y, we just take the 2. That's all. And then del n on del x will be equal to del x into brackets 2x squared plus y plus 2x. And here, if we differentiate this one, we are going to have 4x plus, if we differentiate y is a constant, you get 0. If you differentiate 2x, you get 2. So clearly, we can see that this and that are not the same. So the m on the y is not equal to the n on the x. So this one also becomes non-exact. This one also becomes non-exact.
So let us move to number 5. So if you consider the number 5, this is our m and this is our n. So here we are going to have del m on del y to be equal to del on del y into bracket 3x squared plus 4xy. And that will give us, if we differentiate this one, we are going to get 0. So if we differentiate this, you take the constant 4x. So 4x is the constant. So if you differentiate it, you just take the constant. Since the power of y is 1. Now, del n on del x is equal to del on del x into brackets 2x squared plus 2y. And here we are differentiating with respect to x. So this one is a constant. Don't go there. 2 times 2 give us 4x. And you can see that 4x is equal to 4x. So this one is exact. Let's tackle the number 6. So for the number 6, we have this as our m and this as our n. We have x greater than 0 and y greater than 0 because we take ln of numbers that are greater than 0. We don't have ln of negative numbers. That is why we have these assumptions there. So here we are going to have del m on del y to be equal to del on del y into brackets x ln y plus xy. And here this will give us x is a constant since we are differentiating partially with respect to y. So we bring x. If we differentiate ln y, we are going to get 1 divided by y plus x is a constant, so we put it down. If we differentiate y, you get 1 times this, we get that. So this will give us x on y plus x. Now let us take the n on del x. So I'm cleaning this one. So we are looking at this one. So we take del n on del x equal to del on del x into brackets y ln x plus xy. So here y is a constant, so I'll put it down. If we differentiate ln x, we are going to get 1 divided by x plus here y is a constant. If we differentiate x, we get 1. 1 times this will give you y. So this will give us y on x plus y. And we can see that y on x plus y is not equal to x on y plus x. So this one, too, we put n there to tell you that it is non-exact differential equation. Now number 7 and then number 8 and we are done. So now let's move on with number 7. For number 7, this is our m and this is our n, that is the negative x. So if we take del m on del y, we are going to get del on del y 2x cubed plus y. So since we are taking the partial derivative with respect to y, 2x cubed is a constant. If we differentiate it, you get 0. If we differentiate y, we are going to get 1. And then we take del n, partial derivative of n, with respect to partial derivative of x. So with respect to x, will give us del on del x, bracket negative 1. Negative x. If we differentiate this, we are going to get negative 1. And negative 1 is not equal to positive 1. So this one also is non-exact differential equation. Now our last equation. If we look at the last one, how do we do that one? So let me clean this part. I hope you are enjoying the lesson. Please subscribe to my channel. If you have any question related to this, just leave it at the comment section and I'll be of help to you. Now let's do the number 8. For the number 8, this will be my m and here this will be my n. So here, del m on del y will be equal to del on del y into brackets e to the power x sin y minus 2y sin x. So since we are differentiating partially with respect to y, e to the power x is a constant, so I'll put e to the power x there. If we differentiate sine y, you get cosine of y. Here sine x becomes a constant, so I'll put it here. If we differentiate negative 2y, you get negative 2. Very simple as that. Now, it has left with the n. So we take del n on del x equal to del x into bracket e to the power x cosine of y minus 2 cosine of x. So now, since we are differentiating partially with respect to x, cosine of y is a constant, so I'll put it here. If we differentiate e to the power x, we get e to the power x. And here, negative 2 is a constant, so let me put negative 2 there. If we differentiate cos x, you get what? Negative sine x. So I'll get here negative sine x. And this will give me e to the power x cosine of y plus 2 sine x. Now you can clearly see that this part and this part are the same, but negative 2 sine x is not equal to positive 2 sine x, so it means that the equation 8 is also non-exact differential equations. I'm Mensah Augustine, and you can follow me on my Facebook page, Maths with Vim. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye bye.